In this video, we're going to provide a basic exposure to query optimization of PI OLEDB Enterprise, as well as a detailed walkthrough of a non-performant query to show how easy it is to fall into some of the performance pitfalls. Let's begin by going to the tech support download site so we can look at a white paper on PI OLEDB Enterprise query optimization. Let's go to the tech support download site. And let's filter by PI OLEDB Enterprise and file type of white paper. Here we see the PI OLEDB Enterprise SQL optimization white paper. Let's take a look at it now. This white paper goes into detail about the different types of tables, such as cached, mirrored, main hierarchy, etc., as well as the execution workflow. What I'd like to point out in specific is that the PI OLEDB Enterprise Query Optimizer is trying to minimize the amount of data that's transferred over the network. The PI OLEDB Enterprise Query Engine is a client-side AFSDK application, which means that it does not have direct access to the PIFD SQL backend for the AF server, and it needs to make educated guesses about what tables contain what number of rows. Based on the joins and the where clauses of the query, it obtains all the data that it needs from the AF server, then in the client-side post-processing, it eliminates things that are not in the query, and produces the actual result set which it returns to the client. Now, the PiSQL Data Access Server Real-Time Query Processor, or PiSQL DOS RTQP, on the other hand, is a server-side query engine. This means that it does have direct access to the PiFD SQL backend database for the AF server, and it can use the cost-based optimizer to execute all of its queries. It also does not need to return all of the results and do the joins in the post-processing client-side step, because it can do that at the server level itself. This entire optimization white paper and the performance pitfall that we'll see in the later query are specific only to the client-side nature of the PI OLEDB Enterprise query engine and do not apply at all to the RTQP query engine. Given this constraint, there's a very commonly used option in PI OLEDB Enterprise queries called force order. Since the PI OLEDB Enterprise query engine is attempting to minimize the amount of data returned across the wire and does not have direct knowledge of all the different tables, it can sometimes provide a non-performant execution plan. The execution plan can be overridden with using the force order option. This forces the PI OLEDB Enterprise query engine to return the data in the exact sequence listed in the query. This means that with using the force order option, the PI OLEDB Enterprise query optimization is entirely in the hands of the SQL developer writing the query. Given this fact, it's very easy for a non-ideal join operation or even a where filter to result in an extremely non-performant query execution. Again, the easiest way around this performance constraint is to move to the RTQP or real-time query processing query engine as opposed to using PI OLEDB Enterprise. For those that are still writing PI OLEDB Enterprise queries, however, I strongly encourage you to pause this video and read through the entire white paper. Now, the last thing I'd like to do in this video is to provide a detailed walkthrough of one non-performant query and one very small change to turn it into a highly performant query. Let's do this by opening up PiSQL Commander. I already have the queries typed out, so I'm going to open up that file now. I'm going to right-click on the query window and connect it to my AF server. Before connecting, I'm going to enable logging so that we can take a look at what's happening behind the scenes. We'll go to Options and provide a log file. Now let's click OK. We see that we're connected, so we can run the query. What this query is doing is going through the elements in the WinFarm database and finding the element with the name turbine12313 at this path. It's going to return the snapshot value of the latitude attribute. We see that this query took 21 seconds to execute, and it returned one row. That row corresponds to the correct element, and it has the values for the attribute at the end of the query. As we can see, the query itself is valid. However, 21 seconds is quite a long time to return one attribute value. Now let's execute the fast query. As we can see, it returned in less than 1 second. To prove this isn't caching, let's run the first query again. we see that it's a little bit faster. However, it's still substantially slower than the other query. Now let's go through each query in detail and see what the problem could be. Both queries use the force order option, which means that the PI OLEDB Enterprise query optimizer is taken out. It's going to execute in the exact order of which the query is providing. So if we look at the first query, we'll walk through step by step. The first step of the execution is that it returns everything from the element table and joins it with everything from the element hierarchy table, given that the element hierarchy path and name is what we provide. Next, it's going to take everything from the element attribute table and join it to the element table. It's going to filter down just off of the latitude name for the attribute. However, we did not filter anything down by the element table. We only filtered down by the element hierarchy table. Therefore, when this join occurs, it's off of the element attribute table where everything is named to latitude versus the element table, which is not restrained at all. Then, what we have left in the element attribute table, which again is every attribute named to latitude, we're going to join with the snapshot table. This means we're going to return the snapshot value of every attribute named latitude in the entire hierarchy, not filtered down at all. Then, these two result sets, one for all the snapshot values of the attributes and one for the element hierarchies, are combined in the client-side post-processing step. The where filter clause for the element hierarchy table is applied and only one value is returned in the output. This is what we see in the bottom. However, this explains why it takes 9 seconds. Most of this execution time is spent finding the snapshot value for all the attributes of which we are not interested. Now, if we compare this to the fast query, what we notice is that when we join the element attribute table, we're joining it against a table that is already filtered down. This means that only attributes named latitude on elements that are found at this path with this name are joined at this step. Then, when we grab the snapshot values, we're grabbing them only for this attribute. This results in a substantially faster query execution because we're only getting the snapshot value, which is an expensive operation, for the values that we're interested in. To confirm this, let's take a look at the logs. Anytime a query is executed, the entire query is pasted into the logs right at the beginning where it shows the execution breakdown. If you remember back to the query execution, I highlighted everything, including the slow query and fast query comments. This was to force those comments to appear in the logs and make it easy to find the queries that we're looking for. Now let's go back to the logs and search for that string. Here we see the command that was generated. If we scroll down, we can find where the element attribute table is restricted, and we can see that there are quite a few attributes being returned. The last step in the query is to find the snapshot values, and again, we can confirm that the snapshot values for all of these different attributes are being returned, and the list is even longer than it appears as it ends with an ellipsis. Now, let's compare this to the fast query. Already, we can see that the activity in the logs is substantially less. If we look at where it's joining the element attribute table, we can see that the value restriction is only one attribute. This means that when it gets to the snapshot table, which again is an expensive operation to obtain the snapshot value of an attribute, we can see that there is only one value being returned. This provides proof that this specific join right here, where it uses the element versus the element hierarchy table, is causing a relatively performant query to become extremely non-performant. Given that the difference between these two queries is a seemingly innocuous change to the join condition, hopefully this drives home the message of how fragile the query execution performance is of PI OLEDB Enterprise and how much responsibility for this is in the hands of the SQL developer writing the query. As a reminder, this is an artifact of the client-side query execution of the PI OLEDB Enterprise query engine, and if you were to switch to the RTQP or real-time query processing query engine, all the query execution is performed server-side with knowledge of the PyFD SQL backend for the AF server, and the cross-based query optimizer will be able to be used to execute more performant queries in a less fragile nature. This concludes the video on PI OLEDB Enterprise performance. Thanks for watching.